Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. New scientific reports from NASA's InSight mission reveal startling data about the planet Mars. Data which challenges some fundamental ideas in planetary science. In late November of 2018, the InSight lander touched down on the red planet's surface. One of the most surprising discoveries for investigators came in April of last year, when the lander detected a rumble of seismic activity. According to investigators, to date, they've detected a total of 450 quakes, with an average magnitude roughly the equivalent of a 3-4 magnitude earthquake. The discovery is highly significant, since space scientists have previously ruled out the possibility of plate tectonics in the Martian interior, the hypothetical mechanism that geologists have long believed causes earthly quakes. As noted in a February report by Smithsonian Magazine, mysterious is the origin of these extraterrestrial trembles. While earthbound quakes arise when our planet's tectonic plates grind up against one another, Mars lacks the same internal architecture, leaving researchers puzzled about the source of its quakes. However, as is often the case in the space sciences, the notion that plate tectonics cause earthquakes is a questionable hypothesis mistaken as fact. Indeed, the existence of seismic activity on Mars is just one among several reasons to explore new theoretical pathways in Earth seismology. For decades, a number of scientists have proposed that the Earth-Sun connection plays a major role in triggering earthquakes. Some of the evidence that seems to support this view includes the apparent correlation between sunspot activity and earthquakes. Along these lines, it's been proposed that changes in the geosphere result from a temporary intensification in Earth's magnetic field. In 2020, geoscience has yet to explain a host of strange phenomena that have been observed for many centuries preceding large earthquakes, including mysterious low-frequency electromagnetic emissions, rapid, unexplained changes in the ionosphere, major temperature anomalies seen in satellite images, the observation of so-called earthquake lights from ridges and mountain peaks, and unexplained animal behaviors, including migration several days before a destructive quake. As early as 2003, Dr. Friedman T. Freund addresses these anomalies in his scientific paper, Rocks That Crackle and Sparkle and Glow, Strange Pre-Earthquake Phenomena, published in the Journal of Scientific Exploration. Dr. Freund proposes an explanation for earthquakes which would actually place the phenomenon in the realm of semiconductor physics. In the paper, Freund states that rock acts like what is known as a P-type semiconducting material when placed under stress. Deep within the Earth, quote, positive holes are liberated and flow to the Earth's surface, collecting there without being reabsorbed, which is the proposed mechanism behind earthquake lights. In the 2013 paper, Nature of Pre-Earthquake Phenomena and Their Effects on Living Organisms, Dr. Freund offers a simple summary of his hypothesis, which could explain some of the anomalous earthquake-related animal behaviors. Earthquakes are invariably preceded by a period when stresses increase deep in the Earth. Animals appear to be able to sense impending seismic events. During buildup of stress, electronic charge carriers are activated deep below, called positive holes. Positive holes have unusual properties. They can travel fast and far into and through the surrounding rocks. As they flow, they generate ultra-low frequency electromagnetic waves. When they arrive at the Earth's surface, they can ionize the air. When they flow into water, they oxidize it to hydrogen peroxides. All these physical and chemical processes can have noticeable effects on animals. In the electric universe, the electrical nature of the sun itself provides the missing link between sunspots and earthquakes. The sun is connected to the larger electrical circuitry of the galaxy, and the same electric discharges to the sun that cause sunspots can affect our planet's ionosphere. As physicist Wal Thornhill explains in his 2005 article, Electric Earthquakes, the ionosphere forms one plate of a capacitor, while the Earth forms the other. Changes of voltage on one plate will induce movement of charge on the other. But unlike a capacitor, the Earth also has charge distributed in rock beneath the surface. And if the subsurface rock has become semiconducting because of stress, there is an opportunity for sudden electrical breakdown to occur through that rock. Thornhill proposes that underground processes occur similar to those found in atmospheric lightning. The small-scale traveling of charge results in precursor electromagnetic effects, perhaps similar to the so-called stepped leaders between cloud and ground with lightning. However, larger earthquakes may involve a vast electric circuit, from below ground, through the atmosphere, to the ionosphere. In other words, Thornhill suggests that the Earth stores internal electrical energy, which can trigger subterranean lightning, which may cause deep earthquakes. In this view, massive disturbances of the ionosphere accompanying major earthquakes are expected. The Martian environment is, of course, very different from Earth's. On our planet, Birkeland currents entering the poles spark aurorae and modify our planet's magnetic field. However, Mars is said to have no global magnetic field, and its atmosphere is extremely tenuous. Only about 0.5% as dense as Earth's. When solar storms impact Mars, the result can be a global aurora, which NASA's MAVEN spacecraft observed in 2017, along with radiation levels at the planet's surface that more than doubled previously detected levels. In recent years, scientists have observed other dramatic atmospheric and geologic events, which have coincided with impacts from solar proton storms at Mars. For a number of years, astronomers have puzzled over dramatic dust plumes, sometimes seen erupting up to hundreds of kilometers into Mars's upper atmosphere. As we reported in 2016, scientists studying Hubble Space Telescope images of Mars found an apparent correlation between one such plume and the likely arrival of a CME at Mars. The lead author of a Nature paper on the Martian plumes said of the discovery, "There is a coincidence of both events at Mars, the CME arrival and plume observation. Therefore, it seems plausible there was a relation between both events." A New Scientist report states of the finding, "One possibility is that plasma could be interacting with ice grains or dust lower down in the atmosphere and electrically charging them, boosting them higher, but it's not clear how the effect would be big enough." In fact, dust storms on Mars, which sometimes last for months and engulf the entire planet, as well as the towering dust devils which reach the size of Mount Everest, remain unresolved mysteries. Again, with an atmosphere only about 0.5% as dense as Earth's, how is the dust excavated from the surface and held aloft? In the near vacuum of Mars's upper atmosphere, what accelerates the winds and dust up to speeds greater than 250 miles per hour? And why should the storms be composed of packed congregations of dust devils, as seen in this image from the Mars Odyssey mission? For well over a decade, NASA investigators have noted the tremendous electric fields associated with the dust devils. From the electric universe perspective, dust devils and tornadoes, both on Mars and on Earth, are themselves forms of electrical discharge. The electric universe has always predicted that the Martian ionosphere is electrically charged, even though, unlike Earth, it has no thunderstorms. This viewpoint is outlined in the 2005 Teapot, when dust storms engulf Mars. On Mars, electrical effects will reach directly from the ionosphere to the surface, without the ameliorating leakage via storm clouds that we see on Earth. Unlike radiant energy from the sun, electrical energy can accumulate in the quote planetary capacitor for some time, with the potential for planet-altering events when the atmosphere finally breaks down and massive discharge activity is initiated. On Mars, as on Earth, could an electrical circuitry from beneath the ground to the atmosphere to the ionosphere be driving seismic activity? Of course, planetary science has only begun exploring the Martian environment, so from any vantage point, surprising revelations are to be expected. However, the discovery of seismic activity on a world with, quote, no plate tectonics is not a surprise to proponents of the electric universe. But it might serve as a call to planetary scientists to begin exploring theoretical alternatives, such as those offered by the electric universe.